Welcome, everybody. We got a hot crowd this morning. Hot crowd. All right. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Tonight Show this morning. This is it. You made it. You're here. And we are so glad to have you with us this morning. We're going to do things a little bit different today. All right. A lot of bit different. But Anne Lamott says that laughter is carbonated holiness. So you're going to feel the fizzles and pops this morning. But first, let's get to what's happening this week. So we heard about this married couple who was arguing over who makes the coffee. And the wife said that it's right here in the Bible. It says that the man should do it. And the husband says, where? Let me see what you're talking about. So she opens up her Bible and she points right here and she says, it's here. It says, he brews. Ah, tough crowd this morning, tough crowd. All right, I just heard this. Easter was just last week. I got a boo already. Easter was just last week, and we got some people mailed out their Easter cards to one of their friends. This woman went to the post office. She went to the post office for stamps for her cards, and the postman said, "What denomination?" And she said, "Oh my goodness, we've come to this." And she said, "Well, I guess give me 50 Baptist and 50 Catholic." Let's see what else we have this morning. Well, the weather is getting a little nicer outside. People are starting to get to their boats on Lake Erie for the spring and the summer. So I heard the story of some people last year. They were out on a ship and on the lake, and they didn't have Jesus in the boat with them to calm the storm, and the storm was raging, and the waves were swamping the ship. And the captain realized it was sinking pretty fast, and he said, does anyone know how to pray? And one man stepped forward. He said, "I, Captain, I know how to pray." He said, "Good. You sit over there and pray. We only have enough life jackets for everyone but one, so you're going to have to pray while we put on our life jackets." And lastly, friends, it's tax season, so Sarah and I just filled out our taxes, and we were talking to our friend who's a pastor at a church in Missouri, and one day the phone rings at his church, and he says, Pastor Rob answered the phone. He said, "Hello, this is Pastor Rob," or they asked, "Hello, is Pastor Rob there?" And he said, "It is." And he said, "Well, sir, this is the IRS. Can you help us?" And he said, I don't know. We'll see what you have to ask." And he said, "Do you know a Ted Houlihan?" And he said, "I do. Is he a member of your congregation there?" And he said, "He is." "And did he donate $10,000 to the church recently?" And he said, "Oh, he will," with a big smile on his face. Friends, we got a great show for you this morning. Jesus is here with our special musical guest, you, the congregation, and the famous choir, The Roots in Community. So just a couple of quick announcements this morning before we get started. All articles for the newsletter are due this week. It's the last day to donate clothing. Things are getting picked up tomorrow. And at Council, we talked about what we can do to engage our community a little more, and we're gonna try to make over the front a little bit. So the bushes, everybody decided, were coming out, and we can do something a little better to make that front more appealing. So get your ideas into what that can be. Stick around, we got a great show for you today. We'll pass the peace of Christ this morning. The peace of Christ be with you. Oh man. We can stand up and move around.
Alrighty, good morning, everyone. We have one more quick announcement. There will be cards to fill out for the Mother's Day flowers, and those will be downstairs in the fellowship hall after worship. So if you're interested in getting some flowers, please go downstairs, and they will be available in the fellowship hall after worship. All right. Now, everybody, it is the weekend, and during the weekend, I like to take a moment and catch up on a few of my personal things. And, you know, check my inbox, my emails, of course, and I spend time writing my thank you notes. So I was running a bit behind this week, and I hope you wouldn't mind if I wrote some of my thank you notes out now. Do you mind?
No?
All righty. Baloo, can I get some thank you note writing music? Thank you, Twins Day, for making me question the saying that God made each of us one of a kind. Baloo, can I get it again? Thank you, the 40 days after Easter, called Eastertide, for giving me an excuse to double up on the chocolate I gave up for during Lent. I got more. I got a lot of thank you cards. Ready? Thank you, New Century Hymnals, for making me self-conscious when I begin to sing hymns by heart only to find out that I am completely wrong. Oh, and this one we just did, so. Thank you, passing of the peace, for testing my immune system when I shake the hand of the person who just sneezed. That just happened, Pastor Andrew, didn't it? Oh, this is gonna hit home for some of you. Thank you, pew cushions, for making the seats just comfortable enough to not groan out loud, but uncomfortable enough to stay awake during the sermon. You know, today's a day about being grateful, so I'm glad I'm getting all these done. That was fantastic. Okay. Thank you, lady who sings off-key each week during the hymns, for making me feel more confident in my own singing abilities. Oh, no pointing. No pointing. Uh-oh, I think some people have some people in mind. I'm not looking up or pointing to anyone. This is awesome. Thank you, acolytes, for not blowing out the altar candles at the end of the service and making a wish like it's your birthday. You know, maybe on the church's birthday we'll do that. Thank you, little drummer boy, who clearly doesn't understand how long it takes to finally get a fussy baby Jesus down to sleep when they show up unannounced drumming their drum. Oh, this is my favorite one. Thank you, sloths, for being the cutest of all deadly sins. Thank you, nursery rhyme, Mary Had a Little Lamb, for making me think, if Mary gave birth to Jesus, and Jesus is the Lamb of God, Did Mary have a little lamb? And lastly, thank you, bulletins, for being something to read during the sermon, a fan used in churches without air conditioning, and your receipt for going to church. That's it for thank you notes today. Thank you. Take it away, Andrew.
All right, friends, our gratitude leads us into prayer this morning. So amid the laughter and celebration of this day, it's good that we take time to pause and remember that there are many burdens we carry and we don't need to carry them alone. I invite you to share your joys, celebrations, sorrows, and fears with us this morning so we can lift them up together to God. Do we have any prayer requests, concerns, or celebrations this morning? Yes, Larry and Lynn. So the mic gets there for Bob's grandsons, Henry and William McComb, and for Judy's sister and her husband, Sue and Merle Sundimer. Lynn?
My friend Mary Manzoni had surgery for a mastoidectomy, and so I wish healing for her.
Larry?
Celebration. Yesterday was Earth Day, and our son participated in a peaceful march in California yesterday because that was also for science. And if you looked at any news, there were 50,000 in LA that marched. We had, I think, 150,000 in DC, and it was at 400 plus locations around the world yesterday. So this is peaceful. And absolutely an important statement to make.
Yeah, and that was Lauren?
Yes.
Amen.
And Mallory.
And
Mallory.
M A L L O R.
Jim.
A celebration of sorts. A couple weeks ago, I announced that Danny was participating in the Skills USA. Right, okay. Competition. And his team took second place in the state.
Oh, man. Wow. Congrats. Terry.
Prayers for safe babies. We're officially on baby watch in our family. My niece Stephanie is due, let's see, today's the 23rd, she's due within 4 days. Ashley is, my other niece-in-law on the Bissell side, Libby, is due within another week after that, and Ashley is due a week after that, so, and is starting to show some progress, so.
Yeah.
Safe travels for all these babies into the world.
Amen.
Please keep my sister-in-law, Cindy, in your prayers. They discontinued chemotherapy, and she's entered palliative care. And this week, she gets to do a bucket list trip.
Amen. For Cindy. All right, let us join in a spirit of prayer this morning. God of grace, God of love and laughter, we thank you that we are so wondrously created and that we are made for relationship with you and with one another. We thank you for laughter with friends and loved ones. We thank you for the laughter of children and the songs it creates in our hearts. Oh God, by your unending love, you inspire us in a spirit of imagination and creativity. Help us to use that spirit of play more, to laugh more, and to create beauty in every way possible. Remind us to laugh out loud, for in doing so, we'll heal some of the wounds within us. Not all, but some. God, we pray for those who cannot find laughter today, for those who are grieving or suffering illness of body, mind, or spirit, for those who are lonely and in need of someone to share their time and friendship, for those who have not yet moved into a season and spirit of Easter and find themselves stuck in the gloom of Good Friday. Gracious God, we pray for them this morning. And God, we lift up our own prayers this morning. We pray for Henry and William, for Sue and Merle, for Mary, for Lauren, and Marilee, for Cindy, for Stephanie and Ashley and Libby, and for Mary. We celebrate Earth Day and Danny winning his competition, or coming in second in his competition. Gracious God, we thank you for your gifts and we pray for your guidance and healing. And now we lift up our prayers to you in this morning, in this moment of silence. May these and the troubles of all your people be soothed and blessed and comforted by your holy presence. May we find the laughter within us that sets our spirits free. And in that freedom, may we take your love into every part of our lives. These and all the prayers of our hearts we offer now in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. As we move into a word from our sponsors this morning, I don't know if you all know this, but Pastor Sarah and I, before we got into pastoring, we were into late night infomercials. So we found one of these skits last night, and we're going to reenact it for you this morning. It's actually for our online giving app that we use here, Tithely, or tithe.ly. So check this out.
Oh, my battery's dying. Yeah. Hey, Andrew.
There we go.
Now everybody knows your name. I really like going to church, but sometimes I miss a Sunday. I go on vacation in the summer, or the weather's too nice, or the weather's too bad, or sometimes I'm feeling under the weather. Sometimes there's just a lot of excuses. I mean, reasons why I miss church. I wish there was some way that I could still contribute even on the days that I miss.
Well, Sarah, have I got good news for you. There's a new app out there called Tithely.
Tithely?
Yes, Tithely. It allows you to give from anywhere that you have cell phone or internet connection. And what's best about it is you can set it and forget it.
What do you mean?
I mean that you can give just one time, or you can set it up to recurring payments. So you can just set it and forget it.
Recurring payments? What does that mean?
What? Well, funny you should ask. There's a function on it that you can set to give weekly, every 2 weeks, just once a month, or on the first and 15th of every month. You just set it and forget it.
Well, how can I pay?
That is a great question. You can use credit card or your bank account.
But is it safe?
Well, your information is encrypted and stored in the highest possible rating you can get by the banking industry. It's super safe, or as they say in Boston, wicked safe.
Now you're speaking my language. How can I sign up?
Well, you can give one time, or you can set up an account on tithe.ly, or by downloading the app from the App Store or the Google Play Store. Our church is listed as the First Congregational Church of Twinsburg.
You're right. That does sound wicked easy.
It is. So sign up today and set it and forget it.
But wait, what if I'm here on Sunday and that awkward take the offering, and I gave online. How will they know I gave?
Well, we thought of that too. We made these lovely cards that are in your pews. And if you still want to participate in the offering every Sunday, you just put that in and it says, part of my worship's giving back to God with joy and gratitude from all that I've received. I've already given for this period or I've given online. So today I celebrate this commitment using this card as a symbol of my giving. So you can put it in the offering plate and still set it and forget it.
That sounds great, Andrew. Thanks for telling me about this amazing new app called Tithely. I'm going to sign up today. Will the ushers please come forward for the offering?
Will you join me in the prayer of dedication this morning? Thank you, Lord, for the gift of laughter, for the joy you bring into our lives. We pray that through the gifts and offerings we bring to you today, the joy found in a relationship with you and your Son, Jesus, will be shared with the community and the world so that we may know the joy in their lives. Amen.
Guys, it is time for this morning's hashtags. We do this every week where we send out a hashtag on Twitter and ask for you to reply and respond to that topic. And since today is Holy Humor Sunday, I have sent out a hashtag called hashtag childhood beliefs. And you sent us a bunch of things that you believed about your faith as a child, only to find out that they were wrong. Many of them are really funny, so let's check those out today. The first one is, I believed that God's name was Art, our Father who art in heaven. Our next person that wrote in said, I believed that Noah's wife was named Joan of Arc. Hashtag childhood beliefs. The next person that wrote in said, I believed that the seventh commandment said, thou shalt not admit adultery. Do not admit adultery. That sounds about right, no? No,
I think it's coming.
Okay, see, we'll have to do a sermon on that one, get that straight for whoever wrote that one in. The next person wrote, I believed that Solomon, one of David's sons, had 300 wives and 700 porcupines.
That sounds right.
That sounds pretty cool. Yeah, David had a lot of porcupines. The next person wrote in, When I was a child, I believed that Moses died before he ever reached Texas.
Texas.
Instead of Texas, that's the promised land, right?
Yeah, God blessed Texas with his own hand, right?
God blessed Texas.
From the promised land.
Oh, this next one. When I grew up, I thought they said that Joshua led the Hebrews in the Battle of Jericho. Maybe a little wrong on that one. We don't know. The next person that wrote in, I believe that Jesus was born because Mary had an immaculate contraption. You know, some might say that. I don't know.
Yeah, it's just a little machine.
It's a little machine that just pops
makes
out
the
babies.
Son of God,
yes.
Right?
Yeah. The next one. Now, this is great. I want to know who wrote this one. When I grew up, I thought that the first book of the Bible was called Guinness. Somebody raised their hand. There we go.
Guinnesses, right?
Guinnesses, yes. Guinnesses. Yeah. The first book. Somebody else wrote, and I think we're going to have to do a lot of teaching in our sermons from now on.
It's not looking good.
I believed that the people who followed the Lord were called the 12 decibels.
We had to crank that one up.
We had to crank that one up, yes. That was a good one.
Some moaning.
Yes, we need the drums. All right, and this person, oh my goodness, that was for the Earth Day science. They grew up thinking that God split the atom and made Eve. Yes.
Yeah, that's a thinker.
That's a thinker. That's a thinker. That's a science one right there. Oh my goodness. Another person. Oh, we got to go through Genesis. I think that's what we need to do. Because they believed that Adam and Eve were naked, but they weren't embarrassed because mirrors hadn't been invented yet. Yes. Hashtag childhood beliefs.
Yeah. Hashtag blessed.
Yes.
Really.
Oh my goodness. Oh, this person, oh, I can tell this is from a certain generation. When I grew up, I believed that Moses' real name was Charlton Heston. Yes, from the Ten Commandments.
That's what it says, you know.
That's the voice of God that I think of.
Yeah.
And our last one wrote, I believed that Jesus healed many leopards. I thought there were a lot of leopards in the Bible. Who knew? I think they meant, yes. I think they meant leprosy, but
yeah,
the
lepers.
There we go. Yes. Yeah. Well, that's it for tonight's shows, this morning's hashtag. Thank you for everyone who sent in your funny beliefs, and we'll be sure to keep explaining what really is in the Bible in our sermons.
Yeah, we'll have to work on that. All right, our scripture this morning is from Psalm 100, so it's responsive. If you follow along on the screen with me, you'll have the bold or the all parts. So on your feet now, applaud God.
Bring all laughter. Sing yourself in His presence.
Know this, the Lord is God, and God the Lord. He made us, we didn't make Him. We're His people, His well-tended sheep. Thank you. Make yourselves at home, talking praise, thanking Him, worship Him. For God is sheer beauty, all generous in love, loyal always and ever. Holy wisdom, holy word, thanks be to God. So, we'll take you back to the days gone by, like Christmas time, with an Easter twist. We got a special musical performance by the Roots in Community this morning.
Thank you.
The roots in community, everyone. Rooted in community. Now, am I right? That is the New Century Hymnal version of those songs? I knew it. At this time, I would like the boys and girls to come down for the time with children. Sit on down. All right. Now, we have a couple more coming. Come on. We have all kinds of fun things. We need as many people as we can today. Come on down. All righty. Well, do any of you play an instrument? Yes? What do we play? The violin? The drums and the bells? The trumpet? An instrument, right? There we go. It's an instrument. We can't remember what. And there's all kinds. And I bet you have hit a drum before, have you? Exactly, yes. Well, I have played a couple instruments too. In college, I took a class where we had to play instruments from around the world. And each of us got a different instrument. And I thought I was really good. So I started out with a drum, and I had to hit, and you have to squeeze at the same time. And then they give you one beat. So I had to go beat, boop, boop. And I just had to keep doing that the whole time. Then the next person over here would go beep, 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 beep. And we all had different beats, okay? Well, when I start doing this, and I'm supposed to go, and the other person over here is going, guess what happened? I'm over here, and I look over, and I look down, and all of a sudden, I'm doing what the person next to me is doing. So they took that instrument away. Then they gave me a little drum, and I was supposed to go tap, 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 tap. The other person next to me was going tap, 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 tap. Well, guess what happened? Tap, 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 tap. Oh, no, and the instructor had to keep coming back over and say, oh, Sarah. So we took that one away. We went through all of the instruments until I got the wooden block and a stick. And all I was given was just to just hit that and stand in the back. Yep, that's as good as I could do. But that's okay, because you know what? Together we made a great sound, right? Well, a couple weeks ago, Pastor Andrew and I were installed as the official pastors of this church. So the silliness that's been in here, you're stuck with us. So, this is just the beginning. Just kidding. Everybody's getting nervous. Well, on Jimmy Fallon, who we've been doing a whole skit today, it's a little fun and different today, hasn't it been? Yes. Well, they do this skit called Music with Classroom Instruments. And they do modern songs with all kid instruments. So what's a couple of kid instruments that you think that they would learn? What was that? Kazoo! Great idea! A kazoo? What else? A xylophone. A xylophone! You guys are brilliant. And what else do we have?
A saxophone.
A saxophone! Gosh, you guys are good. Well, we just happened to... Oh, I think we have some more here. So these are...
Maracas. Violin.
Oh, man! Oh, no... Why, yes, it could look like one of those if you close your eyes. Yes. And also maracas. It sounds like violin sometimes, I think you're right. Yes. Well, we have all kinds of kid instruments to play. Here we have a xylophone, and if somebody gets this, you just have to untape it so that way you can hit it. And we have, what do you think this is? It's handcrafted by an artist called Sarah Courtney. Is this a maraca? Yes! And so whoever gets this would play it like this, right? What do you think's in here?
Beans, yes. Money was costing too much to put some change in each one. So, how about this one? It's a saxophone, so whoever gets this one, you can play the saxophone. We have a harmonica. We have all kinds. This one is a frozen flute. We have a flute. There's all kinds of good ones. I don't even know what this one is, but it will go back together, and it will play a noise. It comes apart, too. Who knew? If you get this one, just hold it together. So we have all different kinds. I think this is a kazoo, a little kazoo. Yeah, you've played a kazoo before, right? This might be your lucky day. Well, I'm going to need help because our next hymn, we are going to have everybody play along. Because during our installation, the sermon was about how a church is like a big band on a tour bus, right? So think of this place as the tour bus, and we are a band, and we are going to make a joyful noise to the Lord, right? And whenever you play an instrument the first time, do you do it fantastic? This would be a big bus. Can you imagine the wheels on the side of this thing and just coming down Main Street? Who do you think would be a better driver? Yes, me! I know! He might have said both of us.
No.
You are a very good politician, just kind of keeping it peaceful.
Ohio drivers are better.
I am from Massachusetts. We are not known for our driving. But so, when we play a song, you can play along to the tune or sing loudly. It's a song that I think a lot of us know. It's I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Down in my heart, I've got the joy. So that's what we're going to be singing. I know, you kept going, that's great. So that's what we're going to do. So you can play your music to it, and we are going to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And we all know that when you first start an instrument, we might not sound good, right? But when we all do it together, it sounds great to God because God's just excited that we're worshiping God, right? Yes. So I need your help. We need to, I'm trying to see which one. Okay, this is going to go out in the congregations. We're going to start up here for this one. I need one person to hold it and the other two to hand some out to each person. Okay, so you can take some and you can go with her and you can pick one and just kind of start making sure everybody kind of gets one. Okay. Okay, and look at this. I have my Macarena. We're also going to do the... No, I'm just kidding. Next year, we'll all do a line dance. Oh, there we go. We got some xylophones. I can start here. You can test them out if you want. I actually haven't played any of them, so see if they make a noise. Are they? Oh, yours had two. Is it? Just go with it. It's going to be a joyful noise. I have no idea what all of these are going to sound like together. But, okay. Walter, if you want to come on down and get one for the two of you, if you want to come down and grab two, you can certainly do that too. Oh, sorry. They both come down. I shouldn't know if we could get them up there. All right, but we all know this song, so you can go along with it. You can sing. You can toot whatever you want to do. Well, yeah, that sounded funny. Yes. Blue. All righty. We're going to see just how musical. And you know, we might just start a church band after this when we see who's good. You have an instrument too, Baloo.
Yeah,
so there we go. Baloo has his instrument. It has to be a little bigger than everybody else's. Yes. All righty. Okay. And you guys make sure you each get one too. Does each of you have one? No? Okay. Do we have some extras? Okay. Make sure. That's okay, you just blow into it, and that is how you play it. Ready, can you push, blow into it, put that in your mouth, and then, oh no, put it, you put your mouth all on it. Really push, put it in your mouth. There you go. There, oh, I heard it then. There you go. Oh, this is gonna be a fun sound noise. All right, but every noise is good unto the Lord. So you guys can go sit back down in your seats, and we are going to sing our next song and play. So if you can play an instrument and sing along, try that, that'll help. All right, are we ready? Joy, joy, joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to serve. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the Lord of Jesus in my heart. Peace that passes understanding down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the peace that passes understanding down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. My blessed Redeemer way down in the deeps of my heart. Where? Down in the depths of my heart. Where? Down in the depths of my heart. I've got the glorious hope of the blessed Redeemer way down in the depths of my heart. Where? Down in the depths of my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the hope of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the hope of Jesus. Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. That was just wonderful. I think that the next, I mean, we start here, we end up going to the Cavs stadiums for our next performance. I think we could sell out. Yes, yes. Thank you, everyone. You're all fantastic, and that was truly a joyous noise unto the Lord. All righty. And we will be collecting these at the end, so we'll make sure to bring these to the front when you leave. You never know when we're going to need an impromptu band session for rehearsal practice. All righty. Our gospel reading this day is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 13 to 35. On that same day, two disciples were traveling to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking to each other about everything that had happened. While they were discussing these things, Jesus himself arrived and joined them on their journey. They were prevented from recognizing him. He said to them, "What are you guys talking about along your walk?" They stopped, their faces downcast. The one named Cleopas replied, "Are you the only visitor in Jerusalem who is unaware of the things that have taken place over the last few days?" He said, "What things?"
they said to him, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth. Because of his powerful deeds and words, he was recognized by God and all of the people as a prophet. But our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. We had hoped he was the one who would redeem Israel. All these things happened 3 days ago. But there's more. Some women from our group has left us stunned. They went to the tomb early this morning and didn't find his body. They came to us saying that they had even seen visions of angels who told them that Jesus is still alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found the things just as the women had said, but they didn't see him. Then Jesus said to him, "You foolish people, your dull minds keep you from believing that all of the prophets have talked about. Wasn't it necessary for Christ to suffer these things and then enter into his glory?" Then he interpreted for them the things written about himself in all the scriptures, starting with Moses and going through all of the prophets. When they came to Emmaus, he acted as if he was going ahead. But they urged him again, saying, "Stay with us. It's nearly evening. The day is almost over." So he went to stay with them. After he took his seat at the table with them, he took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he disappeared from their sight. They said to each other, "Weren't our hearts on fire when he spoke to us along the road and when he explained the scriptures to us?" They got up right then and returned to Jerusalem. They found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying to each other, "The Lord has really risen. He appeared to Simon." Then the two disciples described what had happened along the road and how Jesus was made known to them as he broke the bread. Here ends our scripture reading. You guys, we have a special guest here this morning. We are excited to have him on the show this morning. He is everywhere. Sports events, award shows, songs, churches all over the world are talking about him today. People just yell out his name all the time. We're going to talk about a new animated retelling of an event that he had went through in his life. This morning, we have the one, the only, Jesus! Welcome. Gosh, your hair looks a mess. It's like it's been in a Halloween box. Yes, look at this. You look gorgeous,
you know,
Jesus.
2,000 years, your hair starts to do weird things.
It does. It does. That's what I hear. Oh, well, thank you so much for being here today.
Oh, don't mention it, Sarah. I'm always with you.
I think I remember reading that somewhere. So, just recently, you had a big day.
Oh, definitely. Every Easter, I take about a 3-day nap, and then I have a big party all around the world. And it's my favorite day. You know, they say it's the greatest trick that God ever pulled on the devil.
Yeah, we're actually celebrating that today, that trick that Jesus pulled on the devil.
Oh, yeah. I love it when people laugh. Me and the disciples used to laugh all the time.
I hear you were quite the prankster back in the day.
Yeah, Simon could never take a joke, though. I called him Satan one time, and he got all upset. But I was always giving cool nicknames out, like The Rock, Sons of Thunder, Jimmy James, my bro. We had handshakes, dance moves, songs, and tons of inside jokes. In fact, some of the parables were actually jokes.
Oh, really? Which ones?
Well, remember the one about your a splinter in your neighbor's eye?
Yes.
Yeah, we were just sitting around one day talking, and I came up with that. And I was like, dude, take the log out of your own eye. And Peter held up this big stick up to his face, and everybody just died laughing for hours.
So, do you still like to laugh?
Oh, yeah. I think when we're too serious, sometimes we miss the point. That's what my new animated remake is all about. It's about a practical joke and knowing that no matter what, I'll always be around. I'm helping the poor, healing the sick, comforting folks, and making them laugh every day. So when you feel the love of God, remember what I did with my disciples, and I'm right there with you. But just when you think you got me all figured out, poof, I'll catch you off guard. I love you, but I'm elusive.
That's a good way to put it. I don't think I remember you with a beard or mustache, so we can probably just pull that down and we can hear what you're saying. That's great. I think you only had a beard. That's what I remember. Everybody else? I think it was only a beard, no mustache. Well, that's a good way that you put it. Let's check out this clip that you brought today. Do you want to set it up for us?
Sure. This is an animated remake of what really happened on that original day after the resurrection. I'm played by a very good-looking elephant, and my co-stars are wonderful as well. So it captures this all in this little film we made.
All right, let's check it out.
Once, two guys were walking down a road. They were sad. I'm so sad. Me too, but I'm sadder. They kept walking down the road being sad when a stranger strolled up beside them. Hey guys, what's up? We're sad. What? Why? Where have you been? Haven't you heard? Jesus died 3 days ago. He was our friend, and he was rad. Yeah, really rad. Some people sold him out, and then they hung him on a cross. Our friend, who happens to be a girl, went to his grave this morning, but his body was gone. She said that she saw an angel who said that he was alive and kicking it someplace else. Some other friends of ours went to his grave too. They didn't see Jesus either. Then the two guys got even sadder. The stranger looked at them like they were crazy. Guys, seriously, it's cool. How? Then the stranger began to tell them why. Suddenly, a loud rumbling interrupted the conversation. I'm hungry. Me too, but I'm hungrier. Hey, my mom is making spaghetti. Want to eat with us? They asked the stranger. This is really good. Yeah, really good. I love this. Me too. Hey, Jesus, can you pass the bread? Jesus? Sweet.
Oh, that was fantastic. Jesus, wait, where did he go? Oh, just when you think you figured him out, poof, he still catches us off guard. Well, Jesus, I know that you're here somewhere. So I just wanted to say thank you. We learn a lot from you. We will be right back after this word from our sponsors. Hello! That was awful. I admit it. Made that up on the spot. Are you a liar, a cheater, and a wrongdoer? Well, do I have the product for you? It's called Sinaway. This is soap that washes away your sins. It is formulated to soothe your guilty conscience. and it kills sin right on contact, and it smells divine. We also have products to take on your way if you find that you sin not only at home or at work, but on the road too. We have little moist towelettes and all different products for you to take with you. This is a one-of-a-kind product. You can't get this anywhere else. And whether it comes in a pump, spray, or tube, Wash Away Your Sins lets you commune with confidence. Save yourself and others with this soap. This feature, it features the terrific Easter lily fragrance, plus rosemary, aloe, and other restorative. This particular one is heavenly scented. So be sure to buy yours today for only $5.99. That's $5.99 to wash your sins away this day. Well, that was a great commercial.
Oh man, Sarah, did I miss anything?
Oh, not too much. You missed Jesus.
What? That's my favorite guy.
Oh man.
Oh. We'll catch him next time. Our last hymn this morning is Take Time to Be Silly. It's printed up here on the screen, so please stand if comfortably able and join us in that. Friends, that's all we have for you today. Be sure to join us next week and downstairs today for coffee hour after the show. Friends, remember that laughter is carbonated holiness. So make someone laugh this week. May you be blessed with deep joy and spread that joy to others. Grace and peace, my friends. Amen.